When it comes to Mars colonization and trying to create a colony on Mars, it's not every day that you find a paper with a title like this. Blood, Sweat and Tears, Extraterrestrial Regolith Biocomposites with In Vivo Binders. A title that suggests we can potentially build a lot of structures on Mars by using the blood, tears and sweat of the astronauts living on Mars. And that is something that, well, first of all, I guess is a little bit of a strange proposition, but is also apparently an extremely interesting proposition that has a lot of solid backing from historical accounts from various cultures. So, hello wonderful person, this is Anton, and today we're going to be discussing this new paper that proposes building structures on Mars using the blood of the astronauts. Although I make it sound really gruesome, like we have to kill someone. No, that's not at all what we're talking about here. In this particular paper, the actual proposition is kind of brilliant. So, let's start with the details. Or to be more exact, let's start with a bit of a history first. So when it comes to ancient structures, specifically structures constructed by various civilizations on the planet, what's really surprising is that many of them are still standing. And not just standing, they're actually functional and really, really strong in their construction. One of the most well-known such structures is of course the Great Wall of China, the structure that's essentially something that was constructed over many generations using various different methods and various architectural designs depending on the era and depending on the dynasty. And although some parts of the Great Wall have collapsed in the past, there are actually huge sections of the Great Wall that have existed for hundreds and hundreds of years. With at least one part of the wall located in North China, known as the Zhangjiakou Great Wall, surviving for approximately 2,500 years. And so because these structures have survived for so long, despite relatively harsh conditions, the natural question here is, what exactly did the ancient architects use to construct these buildings? Or basically, what sort of a mixture they used in order to create the cement that was then used to construct the wall? And in the last few decades, a lot of different investigations discovered some really interesting mixtures and a lot of interesting components that strengthened the walls to the point where they became almost completely indestructible. For example, this part of the wall in the city of Nanjing, built approximately 600 years ago, was thoroughly analyzed approximately 10 years ago, and in this analysis, the scientists discovered that one of the secret ingredients used to construct these walls, the ingredients that created approximately 350 million different bricks, was essentially sticky rice. The rice that was then added to the mortar in order to literally help the bricks stick together and help the bricks survive the weathering. And various other studies using other bricks from other regions discovered a lot of other compounds, things like starches, things like oils, and a lot of other animal proteins. But this section right here from Yangjing contains one of the most interesting ingredients, something that showed up in four other sites or in four other construction areas of the wall. It contains animal blood, more specifically pig blood. And interestingly enough, this is also one of the strongest and most well-preserved sections of the wall as well. And so it looks like a lot of ancient builders used pig blood in order to create stronger structures. This study right here from 2014 goes in a lot more detail about exactly what was done to create the necessary consistency and necessary strength for the mortar and for the bricks. But in a nutshell, pig blood seems to be an extremely good additive for improving consistency of various types of mortar. Something that was also identified in a lot of other historical accounts from the French, from the Italians, and even from the British. And since pig blood and pigs in general is something that's easily available for a lot of different cultures, it's sort of no surprise that someone tried to use it and it seems to have worked really well. But how exactly does all of this work and what exactly can we do about this if we wanted to build something on a different planet or a different moon? Or I guess a more specific question is, can we actually use this to build something stronger and better on Mars? And according to the study I mentioned in the beginning, the answer is a definitive yes. But how exactly could humans use this knowledge to build something better on Mars? Well, first, let's try to figure out what exactly is making these bricks and these structures much stronger. The scientists behind various studies determined that it's most likely due to one single protein, a very common protein usually found in blood known as serum albumin. the protein that's available in blood of most vertebrates, the protein that's usually produced by liver, but that's usually also found in most of the blood plasma. Now, the previous studies studying the pig blood discovered that a lot of the mixtures created using this compound generally created an extremely strong mixture by encouraging the growth of certain calcium carbonate crystals. And so by using this wisdom from ancient technology, the scientists behind this recent paper decided to improve our colonization of Mars in the future. In other words, they decided to come up with a kind of a recipe for what they refer to as the cosmic concrete. A kind of a construction material that can be built on site using the materials available on Mars, on the Moon, or on any other planet. And this is actually really important, mostly because, well, bringing anything to Mars is really expensive, and generally the less stuff we need to bring, the better. Obviously, we're not going to be able to bring all of the bricks and all of the construction materials to build the actual housing on Mars. All of this has to be done on site in some other manner. A lot of previous propositions involve 3D printing, but we're still not entirely sure what we're going to be actually printing. What is the actual material going to be? And so using Martian regolith has always been one of the possible solutions, but right now it's too crumble, it just breaks too fast. It has to be made stronger, it has to turn into some kind of a brick-like material in order to protect future astronauts on Mars from a lot of hazards and from a lot of dangers. And so in the study, the scientists used the simulated Mars soil and combined it with some of the blood proteins I mentioned previously. And in the end, they were able to create this astrocrete, the material made from simulated lunar and Martian soil. Although, just as the title suggests, they did not just use blood, they also used some of the waste products. Specifically, they used urine. And surprisingly, the addition of urine made the material approximately 3 times stronger. And in the process, they even sort of discovered how a lot of this works. So apparently, when you add this particular protein into the mixture, these blood proteins end up curdling and changing their actual structure, creating a structure known as the beta sheet, a structure that ends up growing in size and then holding a lot of the material around itself much stronger than it would otherwise. And so by mixing the easily available Martian regolith with a little bit of human blood and a little bit of human urine, along with some other materials mentioned in the paper, we could hypothetically create something that would be even stronger than most of the structures here on the planet. But I guess the next natural question is, okay, so where exactly is this blood going to be coming from? Well, in the paper, the scientists kind of go through the math and work out that it's totally possible for a typical mission of 6 astronauts on a 2-year Mars mission to produce roughly around 500 kilograms of astrocrete by using occasional blood donations and then mixing all of this using on-site products, with the vast majority of the material simply coming from the surface of Mars. And since this would rely on a relatively small amount of blood that has to be donated, the blood that would be collected either way simply for medical reasons, after every single 2-year mission, there should be enough astrocrete made to be able to construct a single structure that would be enough to accommodate at least one more astronaut on the next mission. And so basically, by doing this a few times, after a few missions, after about 10 years, hypothetically, it should be possible to produce a relatively large colony simply based on the materials available on Mars mixed with the blood provided by a lot of the astronauts. And since all of this can also be 3D printed, this would be a pretty fast process. You would not have to construct this manually. More importantly, the actual mixture can also contain a lot of other stuff. For example, one of the previous propositions from ESA involved building bricks that would be able to generate electricity. And so by mixing all of this together, we could create structures that are strong, that can actually create electricity, and can potentially do a lot of other things as well. Something that could definitely work well on Mars, and something that hypothetically could also improve a lot of things here on planet Earth. And so overall, this is a really intriguing proposition, a somewhat unusual, maybe a little bit eccentric, but very interesting nevertheless. Although whether this works or not, we're not really going to know for, I guess, another decade or so. The potential manned mission might happen in a few years, but the actual building of structures is not going to be happening anytime soon. Although hopefully it will at some point. Anyway, on that note, well, check out all of the links and all of the relevant data in the description below. Subscribe if you still haven't, share this with someone who has learned about space and sciences, and maybe come back tomorrow to learn something else. We're definitely coming back and talking about this topic in some of the future videos, and I'm definitely going to be mentioning more techniques and more unusual discoveries when it comes to structures on Mars in one of the future videos as well. Anyway, maybe support this channel on Patreon, maybe support this channel by joining a channel membership, or by buying the Wonderful Person t-shirt you can find in the description. Stay wonderful, I'll see you tomorrow, and as always, bye-bye.